How did you get in here?
Peter, Great Expectations, but did it meet yours?
It sort of did, and I'm not sure whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. I thought it was a very decent, competent, robust, and workmanlike adaptation, and that nothing damns it with more praise than that, does it really?
It's not that good.
I thought it was a really likable, attractive piece of work. I really liked Jeremy Irvine. I thought, when you think how awful he was in War Horse, but that was sort of not his fault, I just thought War Horse was so kind of treacly and awful, and this was pretty decent, and it shows that he is a perfectly good lead to play this. I wondered why it was we were hearing it all again. I mean, it's great. I love it. I can't get enough of it. I can't get enough of Pip being beastly to Joe Gargery and being snobbish to him, and the awful toe-curling embarrassment of that. Things like that are just deathless. I can't get enough of them. But why do we have to hear it again, especially as the film seems to be making a bit of a virtue of the fact that he doesn't have anything radically new to say about it, I don't think, unless Catherine thinks it does. I thought it was good, and I'll sit and watch it perfectly happily. I thought there were some very nice cameo turns in it. I liked Sally Hawkins, who's just born to be a kind of Dickens player, and David Walliams as Mr. Pumblechook, I thought was very good. So I thought it was good, but I wondered why it was we were hearing about it again. What's the point when people like the BBC with their version of Bleak House, which was so kind of radical and strong, why do this now? Why do it if you've really nothing new to say, I don't think.
Catherine, can you answer that question? I mean, Mike Newell's talked about this being his sexy version of Great Expectations. Did you feel any of that?
I didn't feel sexy. I didn't feel it was sexy, and I didn't feel sexy watching it. I felt the opposite of sexy. And I don't know why they've done it again. I mean, one sort of depressingly, I suppose, thinks that maybe because of the money and the selling of it.
Christmas,
lovely Christmas. Mm. I got to disagree with Peter, actually. I mean, I sort of thought it was solid in the sense that this sofa is solid, but it didn't have the sort of beauty and
the sofa.
You know, this sofa. the thing about Great Expectations is he wrote it as a cliffhanger. Every single thing is a cliffhanger, and this just irons them all out. And there's no soapiness. There's no tension. I thought, and I didn't think that those cameos were great. I thought Sally Hawkins wasn't horrible enough to be Mrs. Joe, and I didn't think that Walliams was funny enough to be Pumblechook, and everything sort of disappointed me about it, really. And I thought Jeremy Irvine was, I know Pip is, as you say in your interview, meant to be a bit of a little shit, but he was just completely dull as well. And also all those scenes of him welding where he's kind of hunky. He's too pretty.
He did
to
a lot
be
of training for that, trained as a blacksmith.
Really?
Yeah.
He's no Day-Lewis though, is he really? I mean, did you like it?
I didn't like it much. I mean, I have to say, I felt it was very flat and there wasn't much to it. And also, you see all the British character actors in there that you'd expect to see, Helena Bonham Carter.
Yeah.
Ralph Fiennes was good.
I find myself on the same spectrum of all this, but for some reason, in a sort of Dickensian sunny mood about it all, I didn't think it was bad.
Do you think, part of the problem is that it's got quite big boots to fill in terms of David Lean's 1946 version?
Yeah,
even the Ethan Hawke version. I mean, this doesn't really do anything. It doesn't have romance either. It doesn't have camp and it doesn't have romance. And you're desperate for something like, Helena Bonham Carter as Havisham. For years, you're thinking, oh, great, that sounds fantastic. And actually, she's less kind of Havisham-y than she is in normal life.
Do you wish to see Miss Havisham?
Let me look at you.
Come closer.
What do you think of her?
I think she's very pretty.
You can break his heart.